Share the screen. Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. Today I will teach you about graph, right? But I will teach you by using software we can call Mathematica. Mathematica can be treated as a software or a language as well. Why do I have to introduce you this kind of software or this language? Because you found out that when you're trying to represent the data structure by using C program, right? I think you all will face the problem or is a trouble that you try to write the program, especially for the linked list or the pointers. So in this time or this lab, right, I will introduce you a new language that we call the Mathematica, and it is very useful to solve the mathematics, or you can use it to solve the machine learning or NLP or many things, right? In the past, Mathematica program is very useful for solving the mathematics problem, geometric problems, and also I can use it in the geometric modeling. When I was studying in the PhD program, right, I used this for create my software for the PhD project, my PhD project, and I found out that it's very useful. But by that time, the version of the Mathematica is 1.5 to 2.0. Nowadays, you can see that Mathematica programs, the version, the latest version is 12.0, and I think now it's very useful. In the past, you have to download the program and use it as a standalone software. Nowadays, you can also download the Mathematica program as a standalone software as well, but you have to use the crack. Okay, that maybe you don't want to do that. But also we have the what we call the website or online interpreter or online compiler that you can use it, right? This is the we can call the Wolfram Cloud, and it you when you down or when you sign up this program, and then you can save your program onto the cloud, okay? And you can also write a program using this editor, okay? I've just talked about preliminary of the other basic foundation for the Mathematica. Today, I would like to introduce you the next lesson that you might have to understand. That is a graph. Graph, you use graph. You have already known graph, right, from the discrete mathematics course, right? And you just know about the idea or the concept of the graph. But this course, you have to implement graph. But I think if you use C programming in order to create a graph, I think it might be very difficult for you. So I introduce you the new program we call Mathematica. So first of all, before we will implement the graph, right? So I will start from the graph or the graph model. I would like to review you a bit. When we talk a simple, when we think about a simple graph, right? It can be modeled as a set of vertices, or V, and a set of edges, right? That is E, right? Of an unordered pairs of elements of V. Okay, so where each edge connects to different vertices, or no, two edges connect the same pair of vertices. This is a definition for the graph, right? When we talk about the graph, we have V, set of V and set of E, right? If you can see this this figure, right? The circle, the green circle can be called as the vertices, and the brown line could be the only the line segment or the directed line. When we call the directed line, you can see the arrow, right? To show you the direction of the edge, okay. In the graph, right, you can have just only these two elements, okay. And The simplest way to define a graph object in Matica is by specifying the edges as a list of rules. Okay, so if you can log into this Wolfram Cloud, I would like you to try to create your own graph by typing this example one, right? You can type like this example one is equal to graph A to B. The node A will point to B. The node A will also point to C. Node B will point to C, and B will point to D. And then you press Shift Enter. When you type this, and then you move the cursor to any place, and then Shift Enter, and then the program will generate this graph for you. Okay. Okay, please try to type this. And if you finish this, please let me know. Okay, I think you can generate the graph like this, right? But you can see that there is no label. You don't know which one is HA, HB, C, or D, right? So if you want to label it, right? Okay, you can see that this is the by default, right? You can see that the edge will be generated to be an arrow. By the arrow will show you the pointer, the graph direction, right? From node A to node B, right? The direction can be like the arrow. The head of the arrow will be the node that the graph or the edge will point to, right? For this example, this is the node A point to the node B, right? As the for the first edge, right? You can see this. But if you want to ignore the arrow, so you can just type directed edges, and the arrow falls. If you want to type arrow, right? You have to type minus greater than sign. sorry, I didn't tell you, right? If you want to type this, then you have to type minus greater than sign. And it will automatic generate the arrow like this. Okay, if you want to ignore the arrow, so you can use these parameters. You can also create undirected simple graph using the symbol. Undirected edge symbol can be entered by typing escape, UE, escape, escape, UE, escape. Okay, you can, it will generate this type of undirectional edge. But in practical, you need to know the label of each node, right? So you have to, okay, or before you, before you will go one step further, if in Mathematica, if you want to write the comment, right? So you have to put parenthesis, asterisk, and end up with the asterisk, parenthesis, closing parenthesis, in order to show the comments for this piece of code. Okay. So this way we have the graph of 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1. And the directed edges will be 4, so it can be generated this rectangular like this. If you want to, okay, this is an example two. Example two is you want to drop out the head of the arrow, right? The head of the arrow. This is example two. What does it mean by example two or example one, right? If you want to create a graph, right, you can assign a graph into a variable. In Mathematica, the blue variable here, you can see that if it is blue, right? So it means the variable. If you want to save the graph or assign the graph into the variable example two, you can just simply use example two equal sign and then graph like this. So if once you want to show this graph example two, right, you can just simply type example two. So this graph will be displayed. Okay, for this example, you can try to type the example two, or you just want to show the vertex list. You have to know in advance that for the graph, right, there are two sets of things, right? The first one is the vertices or vertex list. The second one is the edge list, right? So if you want to show just only the vertex list of the example two, you can use this kind of function. In Mathematica, if you want to define a function, right, you cannot use the parentheses. You can use the bracket, the square bracket, right? This one, the black one with the square bracket will refer to the vertex list function. Vertex function will show you or will give you the list of the vertex or the list of the vertices of the example two. In this way, the example two is a graph object, okay? In Mathematica, everything will be treated as an object. For this example, if you declare a data structure graph, right? Example two is a graph. So if you want to just only show the vertex or list of vertices, so the braces, the left braces, left brace, A comma B comma C comma D and ending brace, this one will refer to the vertex list. In order to show the list in Mathematica, it can be shown like the set in mathematics. But in this way, this is an example of list. Okay. And also when you define list, right, in Mathematica, there is no differentiate. There is no differentiation between the list and the an array. And the array, I will tell you later, right, about the, but if you want to define, if you define this as a list, it can be also referred to this kind of the set or the list as an array as well. Okay, come back to, okay, this is an edge list, right? Come back to what I have just asked you to do. Okay, you can type example 3 here, right? You want to create a graph A, B, C, D, E, right? This is a set of the nodes, right? Or the vertices. And we also define the next one will be the edge, right? The edge. And then you want to show the vertex labels as well, right? So you can write, you can type vertex labels, name, image padding 5, and then vertex coordinate like this. E to E, because we have E to E. We also have the loop edge, right? This is a loop, right? C to C, C to C, you can see the edge. And then when you type this one vertex labels, name, you can, the label will be shown, the label of the vertex will be shown. Okay. If I go too fast or too slow, you can ask me to slow down. Okay, and if you cannot finish your typing, you can tell me. Okay. Can you show us how to graph with WoobLamp? This one, you can type this into your WoobLamp editor. Can you? Okay, input the command, then press shift enter. Thank you. Mm-hmm. From this example, you may be wondering what vertex coordinate means, right? So if you want, because we have the node or the vertex A, B, C, D, and E, right? You want to put A into the coordinate 1, 1. This one will be referred to the coordinate or will be located at 1, 1. 2, 1, T, 1, right? So E will be 2, 1 and D will be 3, 1. This is will refer to A, vertex A, B, C, D, and E. Okay. This one will refer to the coordinate 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1. And this one is 2, 2. This one is 3, 2. So B will be 2, 2 and C will be 3, 2. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because I cannot, okay, and actually, okay, if I change E to, because E is 3, 1, 2, 1, right? So if I change this to 2, 0, and then I press shift enter. So you can see that the coordinate E will be moved down, a bit down. This is 1, 1, this is 2, 1, this is 2, 0. I change this to 2, 0, so the coordinate E will be here. Okay. I press 2, 1, so it will be back to this. Okay. Okay, I think you finish this one, and then I will go to the next step, right? Okay, this is, we want to show the graph, okay? Directed edge and vertex labels. Ready? Okay, I think this one is nothing. Okay, by default, if you set the graph vertices, right, it will be by default, will be A, B, C, D, right? And if you want to change the label, you can change from A to capital A, right? And the result can be like this, or you can change D to 4, right? The result will be like this. Okay, this is the way that if you want to change the label name, right, you can also change it. Doesn't matter, it's okay. If you want to show the edge, right, the edge name, you can just simply type edge labels name. You can see that if you use the graph, if you want to show the graph, or if you want to program the graph using Mathematica, is very, very easy, right? You can just simply type the object graph, right? And this one will show you and create the graph easily. And then if you want to set up some parameters, for example, if you want to show the name of the edge, right, you can just simply type edge labels and point to name. And if you want to show the vertex label, you can type vertex label and point to name as well. So this one, this very useful, this program. And if you want to change the label, the edge label into what we call the name, right? You can just simply type edge label A to B, right? And then set to E1. So you can see that this one will be changed to E1, right? So the label of this edge will be E1, okay? You can also set up the name of the vertex label for the first in the first parameters of the graph object. For this example, A, if you want to not show the vertex name of A, so you can just simply type A like this. But if you want to show the label of the node B to be B, right, you can just type labeled ED, right, B to B. And then if you want to change D to 4, you can type label D to 4. Mm-hmm. Similarly to the case of the edge, if you want to name the edge B to D to be this name edge, so you can type this. Okay, this is very simple. Okay, this is just simple. If you want to change the vertex size like to medium, okay, you can type vertex size medium. Okay. If you want to change the edge style to green, vertex style to red, but you want to change the vertex color to red, you can just type red. And okay. Maybe you can try this, right? So you can be familiar with how to write a graph object. Okay, I think you finished this one. Okay, I will go through the... Okay, if you want to modify the graph, for example, if you set up the graph object by many parameters, right? For example, the edge, the list of the edge, the list of the vertices, right? And then you can also set up the size of the vertex, okay? Now, if you want to add a vertex, what shall we do? Okay, so first of all, I want you to type this one, modify example here. Okay, and then you can get this one. This is a new object, new graph object, A, B, C, D, right? There are four. Okay, if you want to make it fast, I will type and put this book, this line to your line group. Okay, so you can copy this for the, if you want to make it fast. If you finish this, you can try to add a new vertex, add two new vertices to the graph, right? By using modify example B, right? Example B, modify example B will be a new graph object, right? By using vertex add, you change or modify example, this one is an original graph, right? And then when you add Y and Z into this graph, right, you can, this one will be the change modified graph object. Okay, so it can be shown like this, like Y and Z is are two vertices, but there is no edge connected these two vertices. Okay, this is a add vertex. You can also add the edge, right, to connect Z, vertex Z and vertex Y, right? Once you add this one, you use this one, and then you can see this graph picture. Okay, when you copy the code that I gave to you in the line chat, so you can come up with this figure. Okay, this is a graph. connected graph. Okay, you can also delete the edge from your graph as well, right? If for this example, if you want to delete a node, no, if you want to delete an edge, right? An edge connected, connect B and C, right? Connect B and C is this B and C. This is this node, right? This is edge. So you can get this one. I think you finished this already. Okay, this is if you want to delete a vertex from this graph, you can also do that by using the vertex delete, right? Vertex delete, and this one is a graph variable, and then you want to delete y. So you can see that from this example, if you delete y, age, Y, Z, and H, A, Y. H, Y, Z, and H, A, Y will be disappeared. So the edge that related to the vertex that you delete will be disappeared. So now once you delete Y from the modify example B, right? When you list the vertex list, you can see A, B, C, D, and Z only. Okay, Y will be eliminated. And also, if you want to check for the edge list as well, right? Because you delete Y, right? So the edges that related to the Y, the vertex Y, will be deleted as well. Mm-hmm. So this is the way that we will try to construct the graph easily by using mathematical program, right? So I think you will be a bit happy to use this, right? Instead of using C programming, right? That's quite difficult. You have to deal with the pointer. You have to deal with the memory allocation. So you have to take care of that. Mm-hmm. So when you use this, like, you can just simply use it by using, okay, if you want to add the vertex, if you want to add the edge, right, it's not the problem. Okay, so I will go to the next session, right, next session, that is graph terminology and spatial type of graph, right? This one, I will just to recall you about some graph terminologies that you have already studied in the class discrete mathematics in the previous semester, right? So we have to start from degree. Do you remember degree? Okay, we have to start from example three, right? Have you finished this one? You can type example three. So this graph will be shown. This graph will be shown, right? And then if you want to ask about the degree, vertex A, what is the degree of vertex A? Can you answer me? What is the degree of vertex A? Okay, two, right? But why is that? Why is two? How can you count one and two? What does it mean by the degree? Degree will be the count, the number of the edge that will go to or go out of the that node or that vertex. For this example, when you are considering node A here, right? The degree is 2. How about E? 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. The answer is 5. For the loop, right, you will count 2. Okay, in this case, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the degree of the graph will be like this. So once we have the mathematical program, right, if you want to know the properties of the graph, right, if you know the function, it very, very easy to get the result. Mm-hmm. When I taught the discrete mathematics using, I used a mathematical program in order to show the students about the graph like this. So when I taught them and then I asked them to do like this, right, it's very easy, right, for them to understand about the graph. Okay. So that's for the regular program or the type program. Okay, so I will continue with the vertex in degree. Vertex in degree. Example 3, D is 2. For the degree, we also have in degree and out degree. As it name, right, in degree means the number of the edge that the direction go to the vertex D, right? Vertex D, right? How many? Okay, and when you consider the head of the arrow, right? You can see that in degree of D is 1 and 2, but the out degree will be only 1. So you can have the result in degree is 2 and out degree is 1. Okay, it's pretty easy by using the Mathematica, and then you can get the result directly. If you can remember the function name, vertex in degree, vertex out degree. So now if you want to show the vertex list, so it will be like this. So if you want to show, if you don't want to specify only the what degree of a vertex, right? You can type vertex degree. It will show the degree for each vertex. It can be shown in list of vertex degree. Okay, the first one is a vertex list. It will show you the list or the set of vertices. And the next one, vertex degree, it will show the degree of each vertex. And also this one, vertex in degree, vertex out degree. Okay, it's pretty easy. The next one is some spatial simple graph. We can have the complete graph. If you want to show complete graph, if you want to know what does it mean by complete graph, right, you can just type complete graph 5. Okay, maybe you can check your program. Please type complete graph 5. Do you get this one? Pentagon with the star like this. Complete graph. Okay, complete graph is 5. If I change it to 3, you can get the triangle. You just change. You can also change to 6, right? You can see the hexagon. It's very nice. This is a complete graph. And how about the cycle graph? Do you remember cycle graph, right? If you want to get the nano, we call nano, right? Nano is nanogon, right? Cycle graph is like this. Cycle graph will not show the inner edges, right? Inside the polygon, okay? If you show the complete graph, it will show all possible edges, including the boundary of the polygon and also the inner edges of the polygon, right? When you want to show the complete graph, right, you will show the boundary edges of the polygon and also the inner polygon, inner edges, right? But for the circle or cycle graph, right, we will ignore the inner edges inside the polygon. Only the boundary will be shown. Mm-hmm. This is a cycle graph. And then this is a view graph, right? View graph. How many points for view graph? View graph 6, right? It will be 5 pentagon, the 5. And then you have to connect with this, how can we say, the center vertex of the view graph. You can also try to change the name and then you can see the simple graph. Okay. Complete graph, cycle graph, view graph, vision view graph 2, 7. Okay, it will be hexagon. Okay, very nice. This one's 8. Maybe you can see, cannot see this one. Okay, I will show you what I type here. Okay, I think that's all for the simple graph. So the next one, I'm not sure whether you know about the bipartite graph before. Have you ever studied about the bipartite graph? Bipartite graph is very useful for the problem of matching, right? Bipartite graph will separate the graph or the vertices of the graph into two different set of graphs, right? And then we have to match from one group to another, right? So that's why this is a special graph that we call bipartite graph. I'm not sure whether Ajahn Halimon taught you already. Okay, you say yes, you know, from this heat map. Okay, that's good. So, okay. So, I will just tell you about the definition of the bipartite graph, right? Bipartite graph is one whose vertex set can be partitioned into two disjoint sets. Okay, we have two disjoint set of the vertex set, and then we also have the edge that connect from one vertex of one set to another, right? We'll use this spatial graph, this bipartite graph for the graph matching. If you want to know about the complete bipartite graph, right, it is very easy to get the complete graph for bipartite graph. Okay, so you can type this complete graph, right, 3 and 4. If you type like this, it will create your bipartite graph, right, with the 3 vertices, the first set of a set of 3 vertices and a set of 4 vertices, and then the vertex each one vertex will connect to each vertex, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. When you're considering this one, right, it will have the complete edge, the complete graph, right, the edge to this vertex, this vertex, this vertex, and this vertex. We can call this as a complete graph. And okay, if you type like this, right, you want to put the label, right, of this bipartite graph. Okay, maybe you can type this, right, in order to show you to show you this one. If you want to type, in Mathematica, if you want to use a subscript A, because we have, may have a subscript 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? You can use A, and you can type like this, right? In let's see, I have this one. Okay, if you want to show, if you want to type A subscript I, you have to type like this. Capitalize S, U, B subscript A and I, right? So you can get A, I like this. Okay. As I just told you, right, if you use Mathematica program, right, standalone program, you there will be the like editor that will be very helpful, right? You can type A subscript I very easy. But in this way, you are trying to use the online version, right? So if you want to type the A subscript I, you have to use the function this one, and then it will show you A subscript I. Okay. Or you can use the piece of code that I gave you in the line. one is bipartite graph, right? You can show or you can draw the bipartite graph very easy, right? Mm-hmm. And also this is a complex bipartite graph. If you have three lists of the vertices, right? You can also create this bipartite graph 2, 3, and 4 respectively. So you can get the complete bipartite graph like this. Okay, it's very easy. So bipartite graph will be used to find the maximal matching, right? And for this example, if you want to show this one, you can also use the Mathematica program to represent this bipartite graph of the matching. Make a imp. Okay, this one is to show the edge, right? And this one, figure 10, will show the vertices and then combine them together to create the graph like this. Okay, you can try this example. Okay. Type this and this and this and then create this one. Okay, try this. Okay, I will let you to try to type this for 10 minutes and then during this time you can have a break to the toilet and then you can come back and I will continue teach you at 2:46, okay? By that time, I hope you can finish typing this. Thank you. Okay, have you finished this one? Here is simple, right? To find a maximal matching, right, we can use function find independent edge set. Okay, this is this one, right? The term of independent edge set is synonym with matching. But if you want to try to find the matching in this bipartite graph here, you can just simply use the function find independent edge set of the figure 10A. Figure 10A is a graph object, right? So, and then if you use this function and then you want to make use of this later on, you can also assign this to the name, figure 10A matching. Okay, try to type this one and then you can get the result. A to test, B to arc, C to imp, and D to rec, requisite. Okay, so this function find independent edge set will you can find the to solve the bipartite graph of the matching between the set A, B, C, D and the set of rec, arc, imp, and test. Mm-hmm. So this is a very simple, right? You don't have to write a C program in order to solve this, right? If you want to solve for the manage matching algorithm, right? You have to write a program and then solve the problem by try to traverse along the edge of the matching. But in Mathematica, you don't have to do that by yourself. You can use the built-in function, find independent edge set like this. So it's very simple, okay? And then if you want to highlight the graph, right, to show the result of this matching. So you can use a highlight graph, right? And figure 10A is a graph, and then figure 10A matching will be the five independent edge set, right? This is a function that you have already used here. Okay, please type this and then use highlight graph and then show this. Okay, if you finish up to now, you can write the program. Please press 9 in the chat box so I know that you have already finished until this part. Because I know that you don't want to turn on your microphone and then, okay, this one will be the easiest one, the easiest one. It seems like there are some students who cannot finish this one. So I will wait for your friends. Okay, I will continue with the subgraph, right? Subgraph is very easy, right? If you want to find the subgraph for the given graph, right? It's very easy for the Mathematica to use the function. Okay, for example, below you create the subgraph of the hypercube graph, right? What does it mean by hypercube graph? It will be like this, right? Hypercube graph, right, of three. And then if you type this one, and then you can come up with this this figure. And then subgraph hyper, right? If you just simply type this, it will show you just only the square figure, right? This, right? The figure, the square, right? The hypercube of the square will be the cube of the square. You can get the cube, right? If you use hypercube graphs of three, you can get this one. And then here, and then if you want to show the prism, you can also do this, right? This function is to highlight the graph, right, of the hyper and subhyper, right? So you can see the hyper graph and then subhyper graph that will be highlighted, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, this is a subgraph that is not that difficult. Okay, and we also have the union and complement of the graph as well, right? Okay, you can also see the example of this, right? So I will go to the next one, the next topic that is the most important, right? Things that when you want to represent the graph and then you want to solve for a solution by using graph, right? So what you have to do is you may have to represent it in terms of the adjacency matrices, right? You may be familiar with this name, right? Adjacency matrices, adjacency list, or adjacency matrices, or incidence matrices. Okay, these three representation or these three terminologies are very important in graph because you have to convert from the figure, the graph, right, that will show you in this sense, in this way, and it's very easy for the human being to understand, but for the computer, it's quite difficult. So you have to convert it into the adjacency matrix that we will have to further use. For the adjacency matrix, right, if you could remember, this one is an example of the adjacency matrix. Adjacency matrix is the matrix to represent the connection from one vertex to another vertex. For this example, you can label this one. This one is a way that you if you want to create a matrix form, right? So you can just simply like this. This one is the first row of the matrix, 0, 1, 1, 0. 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1 is the second or the third line. And the last one, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. This one is if you want to represent an adjacency matrix, right, you can write the matrix like this. And then a slash slash is if you, okay, in this line, right, you can see that if you want to represent a matrix, you can write like this. And then this one is a variable that you will store this matrix. And then when you use semicolon for this line of code, it means that you will not show. Normally, if you ignore this one, semicolon here, the matrix or this one, this list will be shown. This list will be shown. But if you use the semicolon at the end of this line, at the end of this instruction, the matrix or the list of these numbers will not be shown, but it will be kept or it will be stored into this variable, example, adjacency matrix M. Okay, but if you want to show it in terms of the matrix like this, very nice matrix, you can just simply use example adjacency matrix M slash slash matrix form. When you use this, the matrix form, the nice matrix form will be shown. So this one will be easily to understand, right? compared to this one or this form. So could you please try to type this one and then show or see the result? Okay, I think you finished this one, and then if you want to show the adjacency graph, right? Okay, we have to start from this input, right? Okay, and then what does it mean by this adjacency matrix? Okay, when you talk about the adjacency matrix, right? This row will be A, B, C, D. Zero means there is no edge from A to A. Okay, you can label this A, B, C, D, if you could remember, and A, B, C, D as well. Okay, A to A, there is no edge. A to B, there is an edge. A to C, there is an edge, so we can see one. A to D, there is no edge, so it is zero. And so on, right? So from this representation, right? So you can also convert from this one into the graph directly, right? You can just simply use adjacency graph, right? Of the example adjacency matrix like this. Okay, and then when you type this, this one will be shown. Okay, type this. Okay, if you want to label the graph, right, A, B, C, D, right, you can just type the labels like this. So A, B, C, and D will be shown. If you can define the graph using the adjacency matrix, you can also define a new graph using adjacency list as well, right? First of all, I have to recall you about the representation of a graph as an adjacency list consists of the list of neighbors of each vertex. So what does it mean? Okay, in this case, we use the view graph, right? But in order to represent the view graph here, we have to use the specified element like this. So it's quite difficult. So what should I do? View adjacency matrix. maybe I will help you to try to type this one. So I have a program here. I will copy it to you. Can I do? Okay, I copy this to, okay. I copy this one. So you will have the view adjacency matrix. And then when you write view adjacency matrix, you can just type view adjacency matrix is equal sign and then this matrix. Okay, this matrix I gave you in the group. We can have view graph. Okay, this is a agency matrix, right? From this, right, I will interpret this this matrix. It means that from the node A or the vertex A, it will point to B, C, D, E, F, G, right? Or the node 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if you write a program agency list of the view graph 7 here, so you can get 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this one, 1, 3, 7. 1, 3, 7 will be here. 1, 3, and 7 will be here. Can you see what does I mean? What does it mean? This one is 1, 2, 4. This one will be, oops, sorry, 1, 2, 4. So this is a way to represent the agency list, right? Normally when you use the agency matrix, right, you will have to show 0 and 1 that will represent the edge of the graph, right? But if there is no edge, it will represent 0. But if there is an edge connect from one to another node, it will show 1, right? So in this way, when you use the agency list, right, the 0, 1 or the 0 node will be ignored. So that's why if the 0 for the first element is 0, so 1 will be ignored or 1 will be dropped out. So this is the way that the agency list will show. Mm-hmm. So agency list will make it a shorter form of the graph, right? If you want to represent this one, is 7 by 7 matrix, right? It's very big, right? Sparse matrix here. Okay, this is an example of the agency list. So if you want to implement it, so you can use this. And the last terminology that you may have to know, that is an incidence matrix. The third, this is the third one, right? You can also write the incident matrices by using the matrix form like this as well, right? This is an example of incident matrix. And then it can be shown. If you didn't put it semicolon here, when once you press shift enter, this one will be shown. Okay, this one will be shown. This matrix will be shown. Okay. And this one, if you want to show the incident matrix, so you can write the program like this. Okay, I will give you some time for writing this program and then show this example. Okay, I'm not sure whether you have already studied about if you want to find the Dijkstra algorithm or if you want to know the shortest path from one node one vertex to another by using graph. Have you studied about the Warshell algorithm before? No? Okay. So, okay, so the next topic is going to be long, right? So I think tomorrow I will continue with this again. I will continue with the transitive quotient, and I will have to show you about the program in order to solve for the, but we use the Mathematica program in order to solve for the shortest path algorithm. Okay, we have the Foy and Warshell, right, algorithms that we have to represent to write the program. This is a Warshell algorithm, and after Warshell, we have to solve the shortest path problem as well. Okay, starting from this, and we will solve the shortest path problem by using Mathematica program. Okay. Okay, if you want to, okay, to try to understand more about the Mathematica program, you can type the program in this lecture, okay, on this lab, right? And okay, I will have to end up today's session now, and then tomorrow I will see you again at 1:30, and then I will talk about how to write a program for the transitive quotient, Foy and Warshell, and then we use this to solve for the shortest path algorithm. Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you very much, and then hope you will enjoy this session today. Bye bye. Once again, if any student who have not yet typed anything in the chat, right, please type this. I will use this for the class attendance, your class attendance today. Okay, but if you have already, if you have no problem, if you have no questions, if you type into the chat already, and then you can leave the room. Okay, thank you.